years ago, this mastodon died at the edge of a glacial lake near what is today Glen Ellen, Illinois. It is called the Hairy Mastodon because the bones of this ancient creature were found during the excavating of an artificial lake on former U.S. District Court Judge Joseph Sam Harry's Glen Ellen estate. By chance, Judge Harry had selected for the location of his man-made lake the site of the ancient lake where the mastodon had died. The bones of the mastodon apparently became embedded in the muddy bottom of the glacial lake. The dense mud protected the bones from decomposition for thousands of years until, in October 1963, as shovels dug through the soil and peaked in clay of Judge Harry's land, a large bone was discovered. Recognizing the possible importance of the discovery, Judge Harry immediately halted the excavating of his lake. News of the find soon reached Wheaton College. Some faculty members went to the scene, and that evening, Judge Harry gave permission for the geology department to excavate the bones. Several days of digging under the direction of Dr. Douglas Block resulted in the recovery of a large percent of a mastodon skeleton. Professor Block and student helpers received assistance from Orville Gilpin, chief geology preparator of the Field Museum in Chicago. The bones were recorded and encased in plaster until they could be dried out and coated with a preservative. The discovery of the skull, with its well-preserved teeth, made it possible to know that the skeleton was that of a mastodon. Except for the pelvis, the missing bones were, in most cases, the small ones, bones of the foot and tail and the like. These and other missing bones were reproduced either by making a mirror image of the same bone from the other side of the mastodon or taking a mold from bones of a similar animal found in Pennsylvania. The reproductions were sculptured in clay, after which molds were made and fiberglass bones were cast. Now the hairy mastodon is complete, and is perhaps the most unusual and accurate restoration of a mastodon in existence today. Restoration of the hairy mastodon was under the direction of Professor Donald C. Boardman, and the exhibit was designed and produced by the Richard Rush Studio with Mr. Gilpin as technical advisor. However, the students of the geology department, who devoted countless hours to the restoration of the mastodon, as well as the many local citizens and area organizations who have donated funds to complete the exhibit, also deserve the thanks of all who come to see and wonder at the hairy mastodon. A few statistics. The hairy mastodon is nearly 16 feet long, over 9.5 feet tall, and weighs between 10 and 12,000 pounds. His tusks, both of which were recovered, are over 8.5 feet long. The scene you see before you, the mastodon, the coniferous trees, and the plants along a glacial lake, is as this area appeared 11,000 years ago. The Glen Ellen and Wheaton area was then much like Minnesota and parts of Canada today. Thanks to Judge and Mrs. Perry, this specimen remains close to where he once lived. Particular gratitude is also due to Edwin S. Dicey Foundation for its generosity. The permanent home of the hairy mastodon has been named the Edwin F. Dicey Exhibit Hall in recognition of that support. And that is the story of the hairy mastodon, another important scientific attempt to understand the past so that we may put the present in context and the future in perspective, and motivate our continued search to see the glory of God in his creation.